my name is Olivia Ortiz, and my partner is Yami Lakshmanda, and we did the 2002 State of the Union Address by George W. Bush. And right now we just have a short clip for you that we'll watch.
Security will make America not only stronger, but in many ways better. Knowledge gained from bioterrorism research will improve public health. Stronger police and fire departments will mean safer neighborhoods. Stricter border enforcement will help combat illegal drugs.
So for the fact check analysis, for the 20 facts that I analyzed, most of them are true. Some of them had exaggerations. So I didn't really find a lot of flat out lies in his speech, but more kind of empty promises made to the American people. But a lot of it was true, and a lot of the promises he said that him and his administration would do were kept, and they did them pretty soon after. An example was, we will strengthen the security of air travel. That happened very quickly after 9/11. There was security right before you got to the gates, and that continues today. It's very strict. So overall, there was a lot of truth to his facts.
Okay, so this is our word cloud analysis, and one of the biggest terms used was terrorist, and terrorism is actually used 46 times consecutively, which is a lot considering the fact that he's only spent maybe about the first quarter of his entire speech speaking about terrorism and the plans. It was actually a lot. Another word used a lot was America, together, freedom, education, and taxes. I put this one up there because it wasn't actually used a lot, but it was a very distinctive term, the axis of evil. He really, this is where he kind of introduced America to that term, which was later on used a lot throughout his presidency and even a bit after. So for the tone of speech, I found it to be really mixed. He starts off with a really emotional appeal considering the fact that, you know, 9/11 had just happened and a lot of lives were lost, so he wanted to share some stories to get the audience to empathize with and kind of stir some emotions. Besides the emotional aspect of it all, it was really formal and easy enough to understand for the audience. So, like I said, it's really mixed. He uses a lot of descriptive words that have negative associations when he's speaking on terrorists and you know, all the fatalities and things that have happened. It's really negative, but then he goes on and instills the audience with confidence in our army in the United States and his plans. He talks about how everything's working, how many camps they've destroyed and discovered. So it's really confusing. I think overall, it kind of left the audience and the listeners confused as to how safe they really were, because he talked about everything that the United States has done, but he keeps pushing that threat. So it was a little contradicting. So the logical fallacies. So the first one is adverse consequences, and I actually have a quote on that. So he says, "My hope is that all nations will heed our call and eliminate the terrorist parasites who threaten their countries and our own. Many nations are acting forcefully, but some governments will be timid in the face of terror. And make no mistake, if they do not act, America will." So I think this was kind of like the main one that I spotted. Just because of the fact that he is essentially saying that if all nations don't heed our call, if, you know, if they don't try to stop the terrorists, then the terrorists are going to keep destroying countries, they're going to keep killing people. And he also kind of puts America in as kind of an authority figure, where it really isn't, because when he says that, you know, if your country doesn't stop them, America will. And that's not really, I don't think he's really in a position to say that. That's more of a UN kind of job. So I thought that was a little funny. He He also uses weasel words, and this one is a little tricky because when I say weasel words, I really mean terrorist. That was one of the main words that he kind of used where he wasn't supposed to, when he was speaking about the thousands of terrorists that they've put away and held captive in Guantanamo Bay. Really, the terrorists were probably in the hundreds. Everybody else was kind of, you know, in the military or just civilians who ended up getting caught in the middle of it all. So it was really sad, but that was the main weasel word that I found for him.
For the truthfulness of the speech, like I mentioned before with the facts, most of it was true, but there was a lot of promises made that weren't kept. But it was kind of, I feel like it was kind of a special State of the Union address because American people were very fearful for their lives and didn't feel very secure at this time. So it was important for President Bush to make the American people feel secure and feel safe in their own country because it was just a very difficult time. So a lot of honest exaggerations were made, you know, to make the American people feel like something was going to happen and something was going to change right away so that we were all going to be safe. But there was a lot of truthfulness to his speech. An example was how he promised the creation of departments that would help secure our country and our borders. And we all know the creation of the Department of Homeland Security, and that actually happened, as well as the airport security that he mentioned. So overall, I think that the truthfulness, there was truthfulness to his speech with some honest exaggeration. For the liberal article, I chose Deconstructing George W. Bush, a critical analysis of the 2002 State of the Union Address by Stephen Zunes. This article was mostly, it described the State of the Union Address as fearful and doubtful in tone. So he thought that it was not a very positive speech. He thought that it would instill more fear into the American people. This article was set up in a way where he would take bits and pieces of the State of the Union Address and fact check them and comment on them. And from most of what I got, it wasn't exactly negative, but it was just very doubtful for what he thought the president was saying.
So for our conservative article, we used one from The Economist, and it's called The Creaking of the Logs. So the author in this article really just focuses on how President Bush's State of the Union address is going actually in his favor. It's actually, he mentions a lot how his favorability is gonna go up. He thinks that, well, he states that even after 9/11, he was up in the polls by like 90% favorability as compared to before. So I think that Bush really used that in his favor when he was creating his speech. He does have one small critique though. He does say that when President Bush talks about the war, he thinks that maybe going into a war is not a good idea, or maybe is not something to boast about in his speech just because of how expensive it was. I know at the time they were going through a recession, so just the cost of war, which President Bush actually went into detail in during his speech, I know it was over $30 million a month, which is a lot. So he thought that was probably not a good thing to mention. But overall, he was pretty admirable throughout the article. I think he just focused on how well this speech was going to go for President Bush.
So for our final score, we gave it a 2.5 out of 4 because of most of the truthfulness to the speech. However, there were some false statements and honest exaggerations in the address. And that's it. Thank you very much.